Today we are going to edit this raw DNG file and give it a sharp, vibrant look with the free apps Snapseed and Lightroom. We are going to start with Snapseed. Again, I want to remind why I'm starting with Snapseed here, especially for RAW files. As I'm using only the free features, starting the edit in Lightroom is not possible because it needs premium subscription for editing RAW files. We have a develop menu here which is available only for DNG files. Here we are going to try to get as much info as possible without losing details. Gonna start by adding more brightness. Next, decreasing the highlights to get more details, especially in the sky. Increasing the shadows for details in the darker parts. Little contrast. Bit of sharpening with structure. Lot of saturation. Here's the before and after. Applying this. Now for selective filters. I'm gonna start in the sky. Try to get some blues by increasing the saturation. Also darkening it by decreasing the brightness. As I'm going for a sharpened look, adding contrast here on the rocks. Also increasing structure. Copying the same filter around the middle. Now on the greens. Carefully selecting the bright greens. Adding brightness and saturation for them to pop. Copying the same on the right. Also one here on the blues on the subject, more brightness and color. Next to the curves, applying soft contrast preset and with masking, tapping on the stacks icon, NavEdits, curves and brush. Here with the effect disabled and brush value set at 100, brushing on these mountains to give them some selective contrast. Here's the subtle difference. Couple more selective filters, one here on the road to make it a little more darker. Not worrying of the effect on the rocks, we can deal that later. Also one here on the left, darkening these to give the lady more prominence. Now with masking, removing the effect on these rocks. this more interesting, I'm gonna apply vintage filter with preset 12 for some vignette effect. With masking, applying it on the right part of the sky. And at the bottom to make the center part pop. After these changes, exporting this to Lightroom as a JPEG for color tuning. Here in Lightroom, in the light menu, increasing the whites to make the brightest parts brighter. This gives the image more punch without losing details. Also increasing the shadows a little. Now for individual color tuning in the HSL sliders in the color menu mix. For the greens, little brightening. Checking the hues, will not disturb it. Oranges, which affects the rocks and the skin tones on the lady. Brightening them a bit by adding luminance. Now for the aquas. You can see the effect on the lady's skirt, adding more brightness and saturation. Also moving the blue hues towards aqua a bit and reducing the luminance to darken it a bit. Coming back to the color menu, adding overall vibrance. Next, moving to the detail menu for selective sharpening. Moving the masking slider with two fingers. Here you can see the more you move towards right, the white areas change. These are the areas where selective sharpening is applied. Now adding sharpening to these parts. Next, I'm gonna just make the image little more cooler by moving the temperature slider a bit towards left, which also gives a nice teal color to the sky. Finally, coming to the curves in the light menu, adding a little more brightness to the highlights. Going back, resetting the luminance values of the greens as they seem too bright. Here is the final vibrant look. Thanks for watching.